Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
We're kind of at the midpoint of the training camp the first couple of days. How about an evaluation of the team and the way you've looked at you've seen in the last 3 or 4 days?
The one thing is, I look at the team, and then I also listen to the coaches and see where they are in their installations and different things like that. So guys are picking it up pretty good now. And like I said, it's kind of like we're ahead of the curve as far as the learning with some of the veteran guys. I think it's because we went to Florida or whatever, and the guys are just caught up to speed. But it looks like we're running pretty good, and it doesn't look like, a rookie camp, anything like that, but the guys look pretty good.
How much of his evaluation and preparation, how much do you weigh that, because you're looking at guys, find guys can play, or you're still looking towards prepare for the season?
Well, it's both. You want to make sure, because it's a short training camp in terms of about 2 weeks. So yeah, of course you have to look toward the season, but you got to be able to install those things first. And you want to give those guys that's not the starters or have been around, the veterans, you want to give them a chance to also come in and compete. That's why you have the walkthroughs and different things to make sure that it's simplified for them so they can play fast.
People at home are asking about Darren, how he looks. How would you typify how he's played?
Darren's he's had some great throws over the last couple of days. I think he's handling it well. He's enthused and he's handling it very well. I like that he's poised right now and he's just doing some good things. I'm looking at the whole quarterback group, and I think that's a good young group right now. So I'm pleased with what I'm seeing there.
They like to throw the long ball. Do you have a name for this offense? It's like opposite of West Coast offense.
No, I don't right now. I'll think of one. But no, right now, that's George's philosophy, and those guys are throwing them. The biggest thing about it is they're completing a couple of them, which is good, and the guys are catching the ball well. And then, defense is doing some good things too. But I'm excited to see how this turns out.
If you stretch the field, that allows a lot underneath for the Jock Sanders-Corey Sheets duo.
Yeah, it does. it does. And that's the thing about it. Being able to have the vertical threats, the underneath threats, and then being able to have the run game. So, it's a good complete package right now. And we have some good talent here. We just have to make sure that the guys are doing what they need to do and making good use of the offense and turning that into some production.
When you look to last year and Jock Sanders, how terrible of a loss to the offense was he, and how important is it for him to be back and healthy so you have a different dynamic there with Jock?
Well, I think last year it was a different scheme, and we did different things within it. I think that Jock, he's just a big piece of the puzzle in anything that you do. So he can play the receiver spot, he can play the back spot, and moving forward to this year, it still will be multidimensional. But anytime you lose a player of that sort, you do have to try to change things up. And I think, George and those guys will do a good job of making sure that, we're covered in all areas. Like I said, last year was a bit of a learning process for a couple of the young guys, but this year it'll be a different type deal.
What did you see in the DD Dorsey?
But D.D. Dorsey, I think he holds the record for punts at his school, and he's blocked punts in the NFL. But as a runner, he's done some good things in the UFL, and D.D. Dorsey is a name that you're going to hear, especially if you've been down south. So he's a very productive back. He's a tough back, and I'd like to see him in the preseason to see how he responds to live action.
This is a guy that has a Super Bowl ring. Is that kind of experience noticeable in the short time he's been at camp?
Yeah, I think we have a couple guys with Super Bowl rings, but you're going to notice their potential, and that's why they're professional athletes. But Super Bowl ring or not, it's not like he was the star of the Super Bowl or the MVP. He was just on that team. So, there's a couple of guys that, you see him, but for him to be on a Super Bowl team, like I said, for them to keep him, he has to have some type of potential, and he does.
You added Livis to the roster. Is that bring him in because is it a convenient move because he was here last year? Just fits in a little. Easily?
Well, we knew that he knew Coach Tucker and he probably would stay. So he actually liked Coach Tucker. So since he likes Coach Tucker, and when we called him, we said, come on in. It was one of those that he was familiar with the CFL, familiar with Canada, and it's probably a little less teaching curve with the guy who understands the waggle and different things like that.
What's the thinking behind having the loudspeakers and the coaches mic'd up for special teams?
Well, the biggest thing is, I got that from somewhere I was in the past. I saw a special teams coach do it because it was so hard for those guys to yell, and when they turned their backs, the other part of the team usually couldn't hear. So I just want to make sure that when you have about 85, 90 players, you want to make sure that the backups actually, they can hear what's going on. Because when you're evaluated, we want to make sure that we've given you every chance to do what you need to do. So it's one of those to where it's good for the players, so we're able to evaluate what they heard and how they're going to put it into play.
Where did you pick that up, sorry?
It was down in Jacksonville. Coach Frank Gans, he passed away, but it was when I played in Jacksonville, and I just thought it was a real neat deal that everybody heard him on a given play.
You study the film. Is there any young guy that stood out in your mind that maybe you said, you expect them all to contribute, but is one guy sort of go, wow, he's better than we thought?
You know, I'll tell you what, I'm pretty pleased with a lot of those young guys, not to single them out, but there's a core of young guys, you know, like I said, some of the draft picks and some of the young free agent finds. I'll tell you what, you know, they're not a fish out of water right now. They're playing some pretty good football and doing some technique things to where they look like they have a chance to be in the CFL, if not on our team, some team.
Corey Williams, you know, it didn't end well in Hamilton, but what can he bring to this team, you know, anchoring a pretty solid linebacking core?
Well, you know, he's a veteran. You know, you always want to talk about that, but he's a veteran with leadership qualities, and that's what you need, a veteran with leadership qualities on the field and off the field. So, you know, he gets those guys going. He's going to break them down. He's going to talk to them, and he's going to hold them to a high standard, so it's good to have him.
You know, have you had a chance to see Drew Burko at all, or is that something that – you know, Kahari's handling, or have you had a chance to see what the young Huskies quarterback
is? I've been to some drills, and I was able to see Drew, and Drew's doing some good things. I think that, you know, as far as where he is as a player, and I think he's learning some things under Kahari and those guys that's going to help his mechanics to become a better quarterback. So, you know, he's where he is, and, you know, he's learning, and it's a learning process for him. That's what we expect him to do, take all this and learn from it.
Levi Brown, how much has he grown as a quarterback in year two?
Well, you know, I can't tell that until it's live action. Once the Bullets get live in preseason, we'll see how much he learned and how much he's been able to adapt from this system and put it into play.